Inspiration is all around us, just open up to it. The other day I made a sandwich for myself. I live in the Netherlands and yes, I love to put chocolate sprinkles on it. It perhaps looks silly to share my lunch with you, but hang in there for a moment. It can bring you a different way of painting. Hi there, my name is Albert van Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, inspiring you to embrace the magic of making art. What I noticed in this lunch scene is a series of layers on top of each other. Let's recreate the scene for a second. The table, the tablecloth or a placemat, the plate and the knife and fork, the sandwich, some butter, chocolate sprinkles. A quick sketch of the scene. I often see people paint in this way. Like they fill in the sketch on paper or according to the idea they have in their head. They only paint the parts they see, or more accurate, just the visible parts because things are often stacked on top of each other, like in this lunch scene. To show the participants of my painting course, and of course you, examples, I found these pictures online. I asked them, what do you see? Their answers were interesting. They talked about food, color or a holiday meal. It made clear that everybody reacts and processes information in these pictures differently. For today's exercise, I want you to focus on the layers you can count. Let's start simple, some strawberries. But I still count several layers. These dark spots represent the surface below them. The blue boxes, the strawberries in it, and notice there are strawberries on top of each other. And of course the green leaves or calyx. And how about the little seeds on the outside of each strawberry? Here's a Dutch ad using our nickname for strawberries, zomerkoninkjes or little summer kings. The calyx is the crown. For my painting I will look with one eye at this picture. I start painting the table and use an old membership card. To create a table-like feel, I have to make horizontal movements. It may look simple, but more natural movements would create round lines, looking like a windscreen wiper. It's because of the anatomy of our shoulder. Pause for a second, stand up and notice how your arm moves, going from left to right and back again like this. A toothbrush for a little seeds on the table. When you do the exercise correctly, you have to look carefully to determine which item of the picture is placed where on the stack. So you can't start where you want, the photograph is leading. So to be able to paint the cloth, I first have to paint the wooden cutting board. Remember, the painting I make is to experience a different way, painting in layers. In a way, it feels to me like honoring every item by painting the shape completely. It can bring problems, for instance still wet paint, although you want to finish your bowl or plate. What will be your solution? Paint somewhere else? Wait a while? Take a coffee break? Let me know in the comments down below. Oh, and remember to lift your sheet every now and then, otherwise it can get glued to the surface your painting is on. Making a landscape painting can be approached in the same way. Like here, while cycling to my day job in June this year. Let's pause for a second. The layers I see are a tree, the high grass, the field, two hares, a ditch, the tree line and the sky. I just love to see a scene like this in the morning. It brightens my day. Here you see a number of the artworks made by the participants of my painting course. I took pictures during the break and at the end. They could choose between a landscape and the food photography. They started painting and asked for help when they ran into trouble. Most of the time issues can be solved by taking a second look at how things really were, trying a different technique, or changing a routine like in this flower painting. The added big flowers can be seen as an extra layer in this painting. Or creating a visual story about a nearby bridge. And a quick flower and food painting. At my painting course I also brought acrylic medium gloss, which can be used to turn acrylics into a more fluid, watery substance, while the colors almost stay the same. So I create a gray, add the diluted acrylic medium and fill the sheet. The whole sheet is wet now and I take a paper towel to make it dry. I add some white lines to make it more look like a wooden table. The first painting I used a light background. This time I want to try a dark background. I changed the scene a little, as you can see by this yellowish part. The paint isn't opaque, so you still see the table layer through it, like here. I just keep adding items, and while doing so I get frustrated over the grey background that keeps coming through all the later added items, adding a grey veil to my painting. I don't like it. It took me a few days to solve this problem. First I wanted to add acrylics, without diluting it, but that didn't feel right. I will tell you a solution in a minute. Let's look at some more paintings of the participants. Creating a painting of food items on a table forces you to find new ways to paint. How to paint corn, like this. In almost all the paintings I notice the later added details that lift up the whole. A base to ground the structure. The light sparkles on the tomatoes. Here, a serene holiday memory. The wavy lines in the middle. The colorful table. This one may look like a mystery, but it's based on this picture and is just a more abstracted version. Back to my painting and the solution I found. At the painting course I showed my grey veil example and some liked it. But during the evening I found my solution. I saw one of the participants add several layers of paint on one item and by doing so she pulled the now lighter item forward. This is why I loved working in a group like this. We all participate and we all learn from each other, me too, just by looking, asking and talking about what we do. Taking a closer look at art, in this case a rose garden painting, can help you understand how a painting is made. Just click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.